Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot, and today we are going to play a little game called, and I'm going to have to Google this quickly, From Ashes. This is a virtual reality tour through history on the Oculus Rift. Very excited. It's been a long time since we did an Oculus Rift game, and I've spent about 2 hours getting this little bugger set up, so let's go ahead and get in there, shall we? Okay, here we are, From Ashes. No music or anything. There's a little photo of Einstein down there, who's looking fantastic, as per usual. Just a little desk, I suppose. Don't know what else you'd call it right now. Controls. Camera reset. R. Play. Pause. Space. Tour guide on off backspace. Oculus menu. Don't care about any of that. It's been so long since I've used the Oculus that it's already freaking me out. We're going to press space. We're going to go for it. Where's my headset? No wonder I don't have sound. Whoopsie daisy. There we go. Right. Oh, this is uncomfortable. Ah, no, it's not. It's comfy as hell. Right, here we go. Come in. Oh, don't come in. Ooh, no. Hi. You here for the interview?
I'd like to tell you a story. I hope you'll hear, I hope you'll see the beauty behind the origin of you and me.
I don't know where you came from.
My name is TV Head, and it's a pleasure to meet you. I'm sorry, I forgot we can't shake hands.
Why?
Anyway, welcome to my world, where we're not bound by space and time. So with that, why don't you join me as we travel back 14 billion years?
Ooh! I'm excited already. Whoa. Alright, TV Ed, calm down. None of that, thanks. Bloody hell. Einstein, no! Einstein! I want to reach out and grab things and I can't, it's freaking me out. You never get used to this, guys. You really never do get used to this. Oh, speaking of Oculus Rift, I'm going to say this quickly while nothing's happening. I'm going to do a competition because I've got the Oculus Rift DK1 and I don't use it anymore because this is DK2. So we're going to give away the DK1 at some point.
We cannot yet see beyond the start of our universe. It remains behind mystery's veil.
Hi.
Did it come from the multiverse? A sea of endless realities popping into existence in every moment? Or is it a cycling universe that expands into existence, contracts out of existence, expands into existence, and contracts out of existence? Or perhaps we are bits of information stored on a godly computer.
The music does not suit this at all.
All we know is that it started with a Big Bang. The whole universe was crammed into a small space. It was far too hot for atoms to form. This is an elementless world, a cosmic soup of simplicity. But space, the distance between you and me, was growing rapidly, expanding, inflating like a balloon.
Teepee had no!
Particles now had room to breathe. And now, atoms could form. Mostly just hydrogen, the simplest and lightest element. Giant clouds of hydrogen are pulled together by the forces of gravity. We call these galaxies. Inside these galaxies, hundreds of billions of smaller, denser pockets of hydrogen form. These are the first generation of stars. Inside these stars, hydrogen is compressed under its own weight, forming heavier, more complex elements, and lighting up the sky.
Wow. The music is still, it's like proper little country. It's really nice,
over
but
here.
Wow.
Let's take a closer look.
You're right, TV Ed.
This star has been using hydrogen to fuel itself for millions of years. Over that time, the star has filled itself up with heavier elements, such as oxygen, carbon, or iron. If the star is big enough, these elements cause it to explode, sending this new material out into the cosmos. This new material can create all sorts of new worlds.
Alright, enough of that. Bloody hell. Freaks you out, I'm telling you. Just stop it! Oh, the music. I love it. Oh.
the dust from all of these exploding stars gathers, and like Phoenix rising from its ashes, a new star is born. This giant cloud is your solar system. Over time, gravity pulls it together, forming smaller worlds. There is only enough stardust in the center to create a star. The rest of the dust forms the planet.
We're very close, aren't we, TV Head? No, not anymore, we're not. Bloody hell. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to be pushy or anything. We can go out, we can get dinner. We'll get dinner. This isn't really one I can talk much, because, you know, he's talking, but this is so cool! It's really good. I want to hold Neptune. Neptune, come here. Neptune, why aren't my hands here? I feel like I should have hands, and I don't, and it's depressing. I think I'm basically going on a tour of all the planets now. Now this is only a feature of the Oculus Rift DK2, which we've only done one video on before. Basically, you never used to be able to do that. And now you can. And it's worth mentioning, ladies and gentlemen, Alien Isolation works with the Oculus Rift, so we're definitely going to do something. Where's my... Oh, there it is. The Red Storm. Other planets aren't very exciting, are they? Other planets are very boring compared to our planet. I know they're not, like, from a sciencey point of view, but just to look at them. Then again, I don't think the game's maybe that accurately representing some of these. I wonder if he's going to put Pluto in. Ooh, controversial subjects here. Is there going to be a Pluto in the list? I wonder what order this is meant to be. Is this from the sun outwards? Skipping Earth. You alright, Einstein? Chillin'? Good lad. Good lad. Oh, Earth. Oh, this is old Earth. Oh, old Earth was pretty dull as well. Okay. Dull in-game, not in life. And we're back to the beautiful music. Oh, hello. Alright, Earth, calm down. Ooh. Earth, no, I'm sorry!
Welcome home. This is it. This is your planet. Earth. 4.5 billion years ago, no birds, no fish, no trees, no flowers, not even oceans of water. Just a landscape of molten rock.
What are you doing, you crazy goose?
But no matter. In time, the surface will cool down.
It's having a Terminator moment.
Each type of atom has different properties and can bond with other atoms. This can create all sorts of effects. For example, two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen creates a molecule of water.
Science. Save me, water! Save me! It looks like Mickey Mouse.
Comets.
Ooh.
Mountains of ice falling from the heavens.
Water, no! Ooh. I'm going to say ooh a lot. We're doing science, ladies and gentlemen. We're doing science. This is really cool. This feels like I'm outside in the rain. Don't actually like it. I'm not dressed for this kind of weather. I'm just putting this out there. Need an umbrella. My head's itchy. I have too big a head. I need a small head. If anyone has a small head they'd like to offer me instead of... Ha ha! Ah! Guys, one of my favourite things in life is standing in the rain. This is beautiful. It really is beautiful. I'm getting chills though. I feel... Oh! You're a crazy one, aren't you?
It's the only planet we know of that has liquid water covering its surface. It is also the only planet we know of that has life. This is not a coincidence. Water is life's wound. It creates a safe environment for complexity to flourish. In this water, trillions of atoms dance. They mingle, they form molecules, different shapes with different effects. One of these molecules would bring about the dawn of life. A tiny machine that could copy itself, like a computer program. Copy. Paste. Copy. Paste. But this machine was by no means perfect. Sometimes an extra bit would be added. This error could lead to two outcomes. Either it breaks the machine, or it improves it. This happens over many generations of the molecule, each time building upon it. The foundation of all life on Earth. This complex molecule stores and processes information. DNA is life's programming language.
Deoxyribonucleic acid.
DNA formed single-celled organisms. One of these tiny creatures would learn to use light as a source of energy. These would later become the plants that we know of today.
There's dinosaurs in this, by the way. I know there's dinosaurs in this. Any minute now. Kids? Thanks.
These plants give off a byproduct, an unstable molecule of oxygen. DNA would take advantage of this new fuel. It would create bigger machines. Machines that could move. Machines that could think. The animals were born.
Bye bye. Animals, animals, animals. Froggy! Sorry. I'm really excited. Froggy! Fishy! Whatever. Don't jump on my desk, yeah? I'm watching you. Jesus. What are you doing? I'm being attacked by a really weird looking fish. Hello? Are you. Oh! 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 Hello. Here, you go away now. We're done with that. What do you? What do you want? Stop. No.
Nature can be cruel, but this is necessary for change.
This is necessary.
The fish had brothers and sisters who were faster, stronger, and smarter. They would not be eaten. With their mutated fins, they would climb ashore and thrive in a new world.
Can you rest?
They had been changed by their environment, and they would continue to change with time and with death.
Death. Death. I love this guy's voice. Oh! Oh! Dinosaur! Hello, Mr. Triceratops. Why are you Triceratops? I don't think you've got the right feel for it, really. Oh, yeah. The feel's definitely not right. Oh, whatever. Hello! How are you? Oh! 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 Stegosaurus! What are you looking at? Hiya! Meow. My face is itchy. Ugh. I forgot how much I love this wing. Why am I not using this every day of my life? Ooh.
billions of different species have roamed this earth. All of them unique. All of them awe-inspiring.
Is this about to be a Jurassic Park moment? Is this a toilet? Am I unaware?
Most of them are dead.
Dead.
We are the leftovers. We are the survivors. Aww.
He's just sleeping.
The environment had changed, killing off all of the larger animals. Now your ancestors could emerge from their holes.
Hello?
Nothing short of rats had survived what giants could not.
I took all you fluffers. Who's my fluffers? You're my fluffers.
Now the land belonged to the mammals.
What's up?
The mammals branched out, taking different forms with different abilities to help them survive.
Back off, bro.
One of these branches belongs to the primates. A creature that lives in the trees. It has hands for climbing and swinging. It has a large mind and strong social skills.
It's kind of terrifying, I'm not gonna lie, guys. I don't even know where you guys are. I think you're up here somewhere.
Some of these primates would find themselves in an environment without trees. Their backs straightened so that they could see far. Now they had to rely on their mind more than ever to survive.
Avert your eyes, ladies and gentlemen. This is no longer PG-13.
After almost 14 billion years of evolution, humankind finally arrived. Fast or strong, you had no horns, claws, or fangs, but you had hands and a powerful mind.
There's no way that happened.
You build your own weapons with a primitive form of science.
Hello.
And how would you pass on what you had learned to your children? And all generations to come.
It's gonna become
you would write it on the walls with art.
It's gonna become a very different kind of game very shortly, I think.
Now that you are conscious and could ask questions, you looked up at the stars and asked, "What are they?" The universe asked, "What am I?" We are literally made from the ashes of stars. We are the dirt, the water, the air, awakened. We are a way for the universe to know itself.
I like that. I like that a lot, that's a good line. We are basically the universe experiencing self-awareness. Ooh.
It would take you hundreds of thousands of years. But once you discover the scientific method, you would transcend biology and enter a new stage of evolution, technology. We probed deep into the programming of the universe, uncovering one line of code at a time. each a single sentence in this story. This knowledge gave us powers that we would have once called magic. No longer were we shaped by the environment. The environment was shaped by us.
A squared plus b squared equals c squared. God, I hated that. Oh. It's just like a family gathering for you.
The virtual world, the world of the mind, took its first form in paintings. A single image, a single thought, plucked from the mind of the artist.
Right, Newton?
You moved on, storing information with symbols carved into stone. Now even from the grave you could speak. Your ideas were immortalized in ink and paper. The first windows into a virtual world were opened with film.
Oh yeah.
You could look through the glass and see another place, another time, another world. You connected pulleys and levers to manipulate the world on the other side. You connected all these machines, creating an information network, the internet. Now wherever you were in the world, together we could play, work, communicate. We could spread ideas like never before, but still, we were looking through a window. But now, in the second decade of the 21st century, the first doors are under construction. Now we can actually enter the paintings.
Holy mother of God.
Hello there. Would you like a drink?
Really? I mean, look at it. It doesn't even have a body.
I don't.
I was gonna drink anything.
That's a bit strange. What about you? Do you want some tea?
Come on. He's a robot. What is he gonna do with tea? He doesn't even have a mouth.
Well, I'm sorry. I was just trying to be polite.
I want some tea. I'm British, of course I want tea.
Now we swim in the vision of the artist. But this is just the beginning of something great. The virtual and the physical will one day collide and become indistinguishable from each other. You may think that this is an impossible dream, but let me remind you of a dream that was once equally impossible.
Are we going to the moon? I think we're going to go to the moon. It's a valid point. Virtual reality. A lot of people still haven't experienced it and stuff. I mean, obviously there's no commercial version yet. It's going to change gaming forever, guys.
But why some say the moon? Why choose this as our goal?
It's going to change the world.
And they may well ask, why climb the highest mountain? Why 35 years ago, fly the Atlantic? Why does Rice play Texas? We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other thing. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed. One small step for man. One giant leap for mankind.
The Earth held its breath, waiting and watching as our vanguards left their footprints on a heavenly body. A feat we once thought only possible by gods. Earth is orbiting the sun, and the sun is just a single star in a cloud of 300 billion stars, the Milky Way. And the Milky Way is just a single galaxy in a sea of space filled with 100 billion galaxies, the observable universe. And that might just be a finite fragment of an infinite universe. So the question is, How many others? How many intergalactic brothers and sisters do we have? How vast is our ancient cosmic family tree, with its branches stretching all the way back to the first atoms? Where else has the universe opened its eyes and asked, what am I? Where did I come from?
Hello. You're bloody terrifying, aren't you? Can you stop staring at me now, please? Oh, this is creepier. Please turn around. Right then. Ladies and gentlemen, that was... this. Oh, From Ashes, that's what it's called. Oh, bloody hell. One sec. There's so many things. Ah. Oh, wow. Well, that was, interesting. New. Different. Really good. Really, 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 really good. Really happy about that. That was... I really enjoyed that. I know I couldn't talk much because it was more like a science trip. What's my hair doing today? I don't know. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it as well. We're definitely going to do more Oculus Rift stuff now that I've got it set up and actually working again, which took me ages. I've just realised how much I love this thing. For those who haven't experienced it and are maybe a little bit tetchy on it and just think, oh, well, it's just another gimmick. It's not. It's really not. It's going to change gaming forever. I was talking about this to someone the other day. I bet Microsoft and Sony, at least, their next consoles, the Xbox 2 and the PlayStation 5, which would be really... they're going to have to come up with an original name sometime. Anyways, I bet they both got virtual reality at launch. It's going to change gaming forever. It's incredible. It's unlike anything you've ever experienced before. And to that extent, I am going to give away my Oculus Rift version 1 at some point, because I don't need it anymore, and I'd love for at least one more of you guys out there to experience what I just experienced. So, thank you very much for joining me. As always, I will link to the game, as always, down below for those who... you can do this without the Oculus if you wanted to. I think you'd lose a lot of the impact, but it's a fun little experience anyway. And those of you who do have it can go ahead and give it a little go yourselves. Thank you very much for joining me as always. Cheers. Much love. Bye-bye.